The Philippines' food supply has long been marred by issues such as predatory pricing from middlemen and the need to lower food prices amid hyperinflation. Now, here comes Sari Suki, an e-grocery platform conceptualized during the pandemic, which aims to directly connect farmers and small entrepreneurs. The platform has set its sights on empowering 500,000 business owners and 1 million farmers by 2028. Joining us in the studio tonight to discuss how Sari Suki plans to achieve this goal is Brian Koo, co-founder and CEO of the company. Brian, nice to have you here in the program.
Hi, Ron. Thanks for having me.
Okay. Now, you're a man, of course, who is no stranger to startups. You've been involved in the founding of several companies. You have Zalora Philippines, Grab Philippines, Gojek, and now we're talking about Sari Suki. Tell us more about it and tell us the story behind it. How did it start?
Yeah, so Sari Suki, as you mentioned, was a pandemic baby. Mm-hmm. We started in April of 2021. It was born like any good startup out from our living room. My wife started doing community selling of fresh fruits, mm-hmm, and frozen meats early 2021. She had a little Viber community that she started selling to her friends.
A lot of us will be familiar with that.
Yes. And just as like any true entrepreneur, I saw it and copied it. Said, oh, maybe we can scale this up into something. So when we looked around the world, the idea of social commerce, where you use and leverage social network platforms to reach out to your to create micro communities, of buyers and sellers, was blossoming in Indonesia, in China in particular. So we looked at the model and said, hey, that would work here in the Philippines, especially.
And they had a name for that, community
group buying.
Group buying,
yes,
yeah,
correct. Which is slightly different from the old group buying platforms where you get massive discounts with strangers like coming together.
Just as long as you had a lot of buyers, correct, buying it at the same time.
Correct. The difference with Sari Suki and a social commerce platform is you would typically sell to people you know, and you leverage all these micro communities that form within themselves to be able to deliver products in a much cheaper way, because logistics happens via the community leader. So if he has five customers, you don't have to deliver to five different people. You deliver to one central hub in that community, and the five customers would just pick up from that community leader.
In your venture, you're aiming to help people as well start their online business, even if it's small. The develop community leaders, you call them Kasari from Sari Suki, of course. But at the same time, you're also helping farmers. Let's talk about the first group first, the community leaders. The way I'm seeing it, and please correct me if I'm wrong, is Sari Suki procuring the goods directly from the source, from farmers. Mm-hmm. You took out the middlemen. But aren't you also creating a layer of middlemen by tapping into community leaders before having your products being taken to the consumers?
True, understood. So what we try to do on the agriculture side is to get products to consumers at cheaper prices. Mm. The whole supply chain of vegetables in the country is very, very ambiguous and very broken. From the farm, there's maybe seven layers. So we've tried as much to reduce the number of layers. So you're right, there's still the last mile delivery of goods via the community leader, and there's us. But instead of having seven layers of middlemen, you now have two layers of middlemen. Because for the farmers to be able to deliver the products to the end consumer, logistics, selling, packing, sorting still need to happen. But what we're trying to do is really to create more value by going deeper into the supply chain. Because if we're talking about moving margins around with middlemen, you're not really creating anything. Yeah. You're just shifting. Yeah. You're just shifting things, right? You're shuffling margins around between new entrants, new players like us, or like the community leader. Mm. So what we're trying to do this year is to go more upstream. And what that means is that we're actually getting involved in the farming.
Right.
So either via contract farming, where we work with existing farmers that have expertise, or we actually rent idle land and start planting. And the hope there is to increase the yield per hectare of agricultural produce. Mm-hmm. I think a quick example here is eggplants. The national average of eggplant yield in the Philippines is around 9 to 10 tons per hectare.
Okay.
In Vietnam, which is not, you know, the country that's much more developed than us, we're sort of in a similar state, mm-hmm. it's around 30 to 40 tons. So vegetables in Vietnam are much, much cheaper than they are here in the Philippines. If we're able to successfully do that and build a proper logistics network from farm all the way to the consumer, you reduce wastage, you improve yields, and reduce cost. So at the end of the day, consumers will be able to access fresh products at much cheaper prices.
And you're also able to quote-unquote control the farms and promote sustainability as well.
Yes, exactly.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Okay, now, if we're talking about community leaders, are there qualifications for a person to become a community leader, and how much capital would that person need?
So the first thing you need is a smartphone, because you need to download the app, and the orders all happen on the app. The second thing you need to have is, you know, a very winning spirit, mm-hmm. you know, a very go-getter attitude, because this is push selling. So this is you calling your neighbor saying, hey, I have so-and-so products. And we carry over 5,000 different items, all the way from vegetables, eggs, meats, rice, and other like FMCG grocery items. Mm-hmm. So a community leader can show his or her neighbor or relatives or whoever they think they can sell to over 5,000 different products to choose from, and conduct commerce, you know, through a very direct way. So it's a lot of push selling. So a community leader, for them to be successful, needs to be very, very, I guess, they don't need to know a lot of people at the start, but they will eventually get to know a lot of people. So we have one community leader in Caloocan. Her store name is called Three Kings. She has three boys. Mm-hmm. Husband used to work in a quick service restaurant as a service crew. Was making taking home 9,000-10,000 pesos. Mm-hmm. The husband has quit his job to be a full-time sari suki,
okay.
To help his wife,
uh-huh.
and be more full-time with their Three Kings store that's powered by sari suki.
But how exactly do they earn from this?
So she sells over 300,000 pesos a month in produce. And the way she's able to do that is she invested a bit in inventory, so she would buy more than what the customers ordered in eggs, rice, some frozen products. And then she would literally go around her neighborhood offering the product.
Nilalako.
So if you see, I'm sure if you drive around the street, go around Metro Manila, you see the guys pushing carriton, mm-hmm. selling gulay. Those mm-hmm. people make money because they provide convenience. So through the platform, community leaders are able to provide convenience in their communities. And if you look at the trend of how our daily essentials have shifted in terms of the channels in which people purchase from, 20 years ago, all the FMCG products, where do you buy them from? You buy them from a wet market.
Yeah.
But because grocery stores have blossomed and they get, you know, merchant discounts and they can do promos, consumption has shifted from the wet market to a more modern experience. But where do people still go to buy their fresh produce? They still go to the wet market.
Yeah, exactly.
Because it's cheap.
Yeah.
It's not convenient, but it's cheap. Why can we not have the same experience inside a more modern format where, you know, produce is not just left out on the street the whole night, where all sorts of insects come in and you know, hygiene is not really a top priority for a lot of the wet markets.
Mm-hmm.
But through a more organized supply chain all the way to the end consumer, I think you can solve a lot of these hygiene issues, a lot of the food safety issues,
yeah.
and a lot of the quality issues.
Now, this is covering a lot. Aside from that, and we mentioned it a while ago, you're gunning to help 1 million farmers as well as 500,000 new entrepreneurs in 5 years. How's that going so far? Are you in line with your targets? Tell us first, how many farmers are benefiting from this already?
So we're a bit behind. We're a bit behind our targets.
It's okay, still out time.
But we do move, I think, close to 50 to 60 tons of vegetables a week now through our network. We have around 8,000 community leaders that are working with us. A few hundred farmers, but what we're trying to measure is the size of hectareage that we're able to plant and source from. Mm-hmm. So we've been experimenting. The experiments have started only this year, but we're looking to expand to maybe 200, 300 hectares by end of next year.
Okay. Business plans. Last year, you've raised more than $10 million in financing. What have you done with that? And are you looking into tapping more private funding in the next years?
We are. So to your second question, we are. So if there are any investors watching, you know, this is good for the country. So what we've done with the funding was really to invest in developing our community leaders and developing the supply chain for the agri side. When we started Sarisuki, we really had a focus on agri. So there are several models of social commerce around the world. Some of them sell cosmetic products. No, classic example is Avon. Avon was the predecessor of what we're doing. We're trying to learn a lot from their success. So a lot of their success is really dependent on, it's really centered around the reseller. And for us, it's the community leader.
For them, it was the Avon ladies that were going
around. Correct. Mm-hmm. So what we've done with the funding was really to help equip the community leaders with a better platform, more guidance within the app to help them sell more, better sourcing of products. So they carry the best set of products that their neighbors need, that their communities need. So it's a lot of that, and the whole supply chain around agri.
Good luck to you and the company, Brian. Thanks.
Thank you, Ron.